Cyberspace is acknowledged as a domain of operations in the same way as land, air and sea. The NATO Warsaw Summit communique of July 2016 affirmed that cyber attacks present a clear challenge to the security of the alliance and could be as harmful to modern societies as a conventional attack, and recognized cyberspace as a domain of operation in which NATO must defend itself, effectively in the same way as it does in the other domains. NATO policy for the cyberspace, as stated in its Wales Summit Declaration of 2014, recognizes that international law, including international humanitarian law and the UN Charter, applies in cyberspace and affirms that cyber defense is part of collective defense. Thus, a cyber attack could lead to the invocation of Article 5 of the Treaty of Washington. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines cyberspace as the online world of computer networks and especially the Internet, while for the Royal Spanish Academy, the term cyberspace designates the virtual sphere created by computer means. However, as the European Union Agency for Cybersecurity reminds us, the cyberspace is much more than just a network of connected computers. It is also about the human element. Malicious activities in the cyberspace by threat actors target not only the physical infrastructure that enables the cyberspace, including satellites, land under sea and cables, and computer devices, but also people through disinformation operations, spear phishing emails, and other kind of attacks. National security authorities, such as the Spanish Department of National Security, and strategies differentiate between cyber threats and the illegitimate use of cyberspace through illicit activities. Cyber threats is usually considered disruptions or malicious activities affecting technological elements, while the latter includes disinformation and propaganda activities, as well as others like the financing of terrorism and organized crime. The cyberspace is now a realm that can be used to conduct information and influence operations. As pointed out by the Spanish National Cryptologic Center in an unclassified report, there are increasingly more attacks in the cyberspace against a country's interest, targeting its public opinion processes instead of computer systems. Audience segmentation and target profiling through open source collection and analysis, and social media intelligence is now more than ever before at the hands of government agencies and non-state actors, including private companies as well as terrorist organizations. Existing divisive issues within European member states and societies can be exploited by hybrid threat actors using social media and other channels. As public relations professionals well know, research and analysis play a key role in strategic communication campaigns as a previous step to planning and dissemination of key messages to target audiences, both in traditional channels and in the cyberspace. On the one side, this knowledge on the target publics can be used to tailor and perfect specific key messages aiming to build public awareness on particular security issues so that we can have more resilient societies. But on the other side, open source information can be exploited in disinformation campaigns that may seek to undermine our civic values, sow mistrust in the public institutions, destabilize our liberal democracies, and weaken the cohesion of international networks of allied countries and partners. ICTs, new digital media, and social networking channels have transformed over the last 15 years the media system and the opportunities for producing and consuming news and opinions, and interacting with the others. The dissemination of content is now accessible for more people than ever before. For this reason, educating the users on critical approaches to the consumption of content is key to distinguishing content from reliable sources. What is news, what is opinion, and what is analysis? Agenda setting and framing explain ways in which news media and communication content can influence the perceptions of individuals about public issues. According to McCombs, through their day-to-day selection and display of the news, editors and news editors focus our attention and influence our perceptions of what are the most important issues of the day. This ability to influence the salience of topics in the public agenda has come to be called the agenda-setting role of the news media. The daily repetition of the topic issue is the most potent way of signaling its importance. That is to say, news media can potentially influence public opinion by increasing the salience of the issue on the public agenda. On the other hand, frames influence what people think of an issue and the understanding and discussion of the world and reality. As defined by Robert Edman, to frame is to select some aspects of a perceived reality and make them more salient in a communication text, in such a way as to promote a particular problem definition, causal interpretation, moral evaluation, treatment or recommendation for the item described. Typically, frames diagnose, evaluate, and prescribe. In the digital media environment of today, social media can have an agenda-setting effect in audiences affecting the perceptions of the publics on which are the most important issues. Additionally, these new communication channels allow that non-traditional actors in the media environment can disseminate content of different quality and intent to audiences worldwide and influence the perceptions of the importance of particular issues. While these changes in the media landscape might have positive implications, they can also facilitate that hostile information influencing campaigns can be conducted through different activities and techniques, like defective and false identities or fake sites, bots, forgeries, and AI-generated forgeries, that is, deepfakes, strategic leaks, and others. Our digital era provides new opportunities for the conduction of covert influence activities by hybrid threat actors that may pose a challenge for Western-style liberal democracies. Adam Bienkoff, in an article for the newspaper The Guardian, wrote on a covert information influence practice known as astroturfing, defining it as the attempt to create an impression of widespread grassroots support for a policy, individual or product where little such support exists. Multiple online identities and fake pressure groups are used to mislead the public into believing that the position of the astroturfer is the commonly held view. A March 2017 paper by researchers of the Indiana University and University of Southern California estimated that between 9 and 15% of Twitter accounts were bots. Some of these kind of covert political influence techniques are just an adaptation of reflexive control practices and active measures to our globalized world and the new digital environment, and are well known by intelligence practitioners, foreign policy analysts, and experts in academia, since these tools have been employed in the past, remarkably during the Cold War, to influence political outcomes in other countries. Reflexive control, a theory and practice developed in the USSR, understand that in human conflicts, the actors involved try to influence their adversary decision-making process by forcing that adversary to make decisions predetermined by the influencing party. According to Vladimir Lefebvre, this can be achieved by sending specially selected information, and this practice is named as reflexive control. For example, the dissemination of false information or a mixture of right and false information are forms of such control. As explained by a former CIA Deputy Director of Operations, the range of activities conducted by the KGB during the Cold War included written and oral disinformation, forgeries, false rumors, unattributed or gray, and falsely attributed or black propaganda, the control and manipulation of media assets, the use of agents of influence, clandestine radios, international front organizations, support for international subversive groups and terrorist organizations, and political blackmail. These activities either were conducted in a way unattributable to the foreign influencer, sponsor country, or allowed plausible deniability. Firstly, in this context, disinformation, as defined by the Mitrohin KGB lexicon, consisted on the secret channeling towards an adversary of false information, especially prepared materials and fabricated documents designed to mislead him and prompt him to make decisions and measures which fit in with the plans and intentions of the perpetrator. Secondly, press placements, another information influencing technique, consist of falsely attributed or non-attributed press materials aiming to reinforce overt propaganda items placed in the foreign media. Articles published in foreign publications aim at local audiences that can be replayed by other assets. Finally, forgeries are reports or other fake documents deliberately prepared and disseminated with the help of mass media in order to compromise politically the policy of another state, the activity of its agencies and institutions, political organizations or individuals. The democratization of digital communication technology for the creation of high quality or semi-professional digital contents, developments in artificial intelligence for the generation of fake news articles and audiovisual forgeries, and the possibility of rapidly disseminating content through social media and live streaming platforms for virtually anybody with some basic digital skills provide new opportunities for hostile influencing activities in the cyberspace by malign state and non-state actors. Since the penetration rate of digital media is growing at a rapid pace, European populations will be increasingly vulnerable to target hostile communication campaigns. Cyber influence awareness, persuasive communication literacy, and instilling and expanding critical thinking approaches to information and social media consumption is critical to develop the resilience capacity of our societies in order to counter covert influence programs targeting larger populations.